DNS-based Eulerian-Lagrangian models are a particular category of CFD models to simulate turbulent particle-laden flows. The name indicates that, in these models, the Eulerian-Lagrangian approach is adopted to describe the motion of the two phases, and a DNS-like approach is employed to describe the turbulence of the fluid phase. The Eulerian-Lagrangian approach relies on the Eulerian cell-based representation of the flow of the fluid through the numerical solution of the mass and momentum conservation equations, whereas the movement of the solid phase is reproduced by solving the Lagrangian equation of motion for a certain number of computational particles. The DNS approach means that all the scales of the fluid turbulence are resolved, from the biggest one, which is the integral scale, down to the smallest one, which is the Kolmogorov scale. Let us now discuss the implications of resolving all turbulence scales of the fluid flow. To this aim, let us consider a single phase flow. It's intuitive that turbulence is a chaotic, rapidly varying phenomenon, and therefore the Kolmogorov space and time scales are very small. The question is, how small are they? Consider a turbulent flow with characteristic length at the integral scale, L capital lambda, and characteristic velocity at the integral scale, U capital lambda. The integral scale Reynolds number, Re capital lambda, can be defined as L capital lambda times U capital lambda divided by the kinematic viscosity of the fluid, nu. According to the Kolmogorov theory of turbulence, the Kolmogorov length scale, L small lambda, is of the order of L capital lambda times Re capital lambda to the power minus 3 divided by 4. Whereas the Kolmogorov time scale, tau small lambda, is of the order of L capital lambda divided by U capital lambda times Re capital lambda to the power minus 1 divided by 2. But what is the meaning of L small lambda and tau small lambda? Broadly speaking, L small lambda is the characteristic size of the smallest turbulent structures of the flow, often referred to as eddies, whereas the tau small lambda is a measure of their lifetime. Out of example, let us now consider the turbulent flow in a circular pipe. In particular, let us consider the following data. Pipe diameter equal to 10 cm, inlet bulk mean velocity equal to 1 meter per second, and kinematic viscosity of the carrier fluid equal to 10 to the minus 6 square meters per second, as characteristic of water. The integral length scale and the integral velocity scale are of the order of the pipe diameter and the inlet bulk mean velocity. Therefore, L capital lambda is of the order of 10 cm, and U capital lambda is of the order of 1 meter per second. Thus, the integral scale Reynolds number, Re capital lambda, is of the order of 10 to the fifth power. Applying the formulas previously introduced, the Kolmogorov length and time scales are of the order of 10 to the minus 5 meter and 10 to the minus 4 seconds, respectively. If I wish to simulate this flow via the DNS approach, I have to reproduce even the smallest turbulent structures. As a consequence, the characteristic size of the computational cells, delta r, must be smaller than L small lambda, and the time step size for time integration, delta t, must be smaller than tau small lambda. It is evident that such levels of discretization require considerable computational resources, explaining why the use of DNS is limited to academic research. DNS involves the solution of the Navier-Stokes equations resolving all turbulent scales. The Navier-Stokes equations are the mass and momentum balances for a Newtonian fluid. In the case of incompressible flow, the mass conservation equation implies the zero divergence of the instantaneous velocity field, that is, nabla dot u equal to zero. The momentum conservation equation states that the time rate change of momentum of a small fluid element plus the momentum fluxes through its phases are balanced by the forces acting on it, which can divide it into mass forces, in practice the gravitational force, and surface forces. The equation can be written in the following form. D rho f u over dt plus nabla dot rho f u u equal to rho f times the gravitational acceleration vector g minus the gradient of pressure plus the dynamic viscosity mu f times the Laplacian of u. When resolved numerically, the Navier-Stokes equations provide the instantaneous velocity and pressure in a finite set of space points and time instants.